Brendan, you're across what is developing in Australia, but you're also very close to what's happening internationally. Are you seeing the developments happening internationally similar to what Alette has described about incoming mandated reporting requirements in Australia, or are you seeing differences? Do you see Europe is ahead or behind, or we're ahead or behind? What's your sort of sense of the state of play?
The first main distinction I would see between Australia and the European context is you have this alignment, that was the reason for my question, between the consultation document and S2, IFRS S2 in particular. And you are, as you indicated, focused very much on the investment community. Now in Europe, we also have regulation imminent, but there is not the same level of alignment in terms of objectives of the reporting. In Europe, the focus of the reporting is now at the moment more extensive than the International Sustainability Standards Board's two standards, number one. I'll come back to that in a moment. Yeah. But number two, the focus of the reporting, it has to be on the impact of the company on maybe its human capital, climate, other elements of the environment, and the impact of those various elements on the company. Now the latter is the focus of the ISSB, Sustainability Standards Board, and of the consultation document here in the Netherlands. So this is a term used for these two types of materiality, impact and financial materiality. And we have this newly overused term called double materiality, which is central to the European regulation. The second thing I would indicate in relation to that is there are discussions now, particularly in Europe, around a concept called interoperability. I apologize. And the idea that we still have lots of other frameworks out there which deal with both this so-called impact materiality and this financial materiality. Companies are saying in Europe, okay, I've got the European regulations, I've got the ISSB standards. And by the way, I do also comply with GRI because I've been reporting against GRI for the past 20 years. So how do I align all of these to make sure I'm not repeating work and using up scarce resources just to comply with these various voluntary and regulated frameworks? And this interoperability project, which the ISSB has undertaken, is indicating we're going to have an alignment between all of these around the regulation especially.